So as we know, we are discussing about our lesson, and the name of our lesson is called Methods of Preserving Food. In that already we have discussed some traditional method, that and we have discussed about drying, cooling, then also we have discussed about the boiling and packing into the airtight cans. Okay, but after that we will discuss today one more method, that is what? Food preservation and its method, and in that we add different types of the chemicals. Okay, now chemicals, why to add in that food? Because to keep the food material for the long period of the time. Okay, so to keep the food material for the long period of the time, we are adding certain types of the substances in it. Okay, and that substances which helps to keep the food for the long period of the time, that substances are called as preservatives. Okay, so it is very, very important concept, students. So keep in your mind, preservative means what? It is the substances which we are adding into the substance, or the different types of the substances, to keep that particular foodstuff for the long period of the time. Okay, so there are the different preservatives, there are the different food materials that act as a preservatives. Okay, so some chemicals also act as a preservative. In the some substances, into some food stuff, we are adding different types of the chemicals which act as a preservatives. Preservative means what? Which helps to keep the food for the long period of the times. Okay, so let's see which are the chemical preservatives. First we'll discuss about the chemical method. Why chemical methods? Because in that we are adding some chemicals as a preservatives. Okay, so which chemicals we are adding as a preservatives? We can say that sodium benzoate and sodium metabisulfite. Okay, so these two chemicals is act as a chemical preservatives. Okay, and it helps to keep the food stuff or food material for the long period of time. So like that, there are the certain, or there are the so many things, food materials are present in our kitchen, and among that some substances are act as a preservatives. Okay, so we'll discuss all that preservatives one by one. First one, so preservation by common salt. Okay, so to preserve the food, we are adding or we are using the salt. So the salt is also act as a preservatives. Okay, so which substances we are preserving with the use of the common salt? So the substances like meat and fish, we are preserving by adding the salt in it. Okay, so the methods of preservation by adding common salt, and this method is also called as what? Salting. Okay, salting means what? The adding the excessive amount of the salt in the food material to keep the food material for a long period of a time. That method we can say that what? Salting. So the salt is also act as a preservative. Now let's see the next method, or the next preservative, the preservation by sugar. Okay, so the sometimes sugar is also act as a preservative. Sugar is also helps to keep the certain substances for a long period of a time. So let's see which substances we can preserve by using the sugar. We can say that preservation by sugar, so the substances like jams and jellies. Okay, so the substances like jams and jellies can get preserved by adding the more amount of the sugar. So see, just now we have faced the summer, summer season. Okay, in summer season our mother, our grandmother is preparing so many different things. They are making the so many different things from the mango, like we can say the moramba is there. Okay, so we can say the so many different products of the mango pulp. Okay, so in that they are adding the more amount of the sugar. Why? To keep them for a long period of time. In that sugar it act as a preservatives. Okay, so in that jams and jellies can get preserved by the sugar, and adding the sugar in excessive amount, this method is also called as what? Sweetening method. Okay, that method is called as what? Sweetening. Okay, now let's see the next preservative, that is preservation by oil and vinegar. Okay, so here is the next preservation of preservatives, that are oil and vinegar. Oil and vinegar is also act as a preservative. They are also helps to keep the food for the long period of the time, or keep the food fresh for a long period of a time. So this oil and vinegar mostly we are adding into the pickles to keep the pickles for the long period of a time, to increase the time duration for the pickle, to use the pickle for the long period of a time. Okay, so in this way oil and vinegar is act as a preservatives in a pickle. So this is all the different types of the preservatives we are adding into the different foodstuffs to keep the foodstuff for a long period of a time. Also we among with these some preservatives we can say that asafoetida we are commonly called as a hing, and sometimes of the mustard seeds also act as a preservative. They also helps the food to keep or to keep the food properly for the long period of a time. Okay, so these are the certain types of the preservatives, and also we have seen some chemical preservatives also which helps to keep a food fresh for the long period of time. So now we will see the one important method to preserve the food, or there is a one method, in that method we can preserve the food. Okay, so the name of the method is heat and cold treatments. Okay, heat and cold treatments. So this heat and cold treatment is nothing but what? Pasteurization method. What? Heat and cold treatment is nothing but which method? Pasteurization method. So as we know, this pasteurization method was invented by the great scientist Louis Pasteur. Okay, so because of his name, this method was given the name, that is what? Pasteurization method. So what happens in this pasteurization method? See, here only we have written that heat and cold treatment. Means what happened? We are providing heat also, and we are putting that substance also. Okay, so we are providing heat for the food stuff. Also, we are providing the cold, or we are keeping that food stuff cold also. Okay, so in this way, heat and cold, both the things we are providing to that certain substance. So let's see what exactly happened in the pasteurization. Let's see. So we are heating the substance on the 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 seconds. Okay, so heating the substances on a 70 degree Celsius 15 to 30 seconds, and then suddenly chilled suddenly. Okay, after the excessive heat, then suddenly the substance get chilled, or we are providing cold to that particular food material. So because of this excessive heat and this sudden chill, what happened? Whatever the pathogens means what? Whatever the bacteria which are present in the food material all get destroyed or all get killed, and we can use that food material for the some more extra time, or we will get the more time to use that particular food material. Okay, we can say that mostly the milk and the milk products we are storing them, or we are using this pasteurization method mostly for the dairy products. Okay, so if you have seen the milk packet, so on that it is written that pasteurized milk. Okay, now what is mean by pasteurized milk? Means what happened? The milk is get suddenly heat, and then it get excessive heat, and then it get chilled suddenly. So we can increase the lifetime or the using period of a particular food material. Okay, so this is all about what? Heat and cold treatment, that is called as what? Pasteurization method. What is it happens in that? We have to give heat to the food substance, that is on 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 13 seconds, and then we have to chill that particular food substance suddenly. Okay, so this is all about today. What we have discussed today? We have discussed today about the preservatives. So the preservatives are the special substances which we are adding into the food stuff, which helps to keep the food for the long period of time. There are the certain chemicals which act as a preservative, such as sodium benzoate, sodium metabisulfite, preservation by common salt, which food stuff we are preserving, meat and fish, preservation by sugar, which substances we are preserving, jams and jellies, with the help of the oil and vinegar we can preserve pickles. So this is all about today. So today I will end my point. For the next period we will see the next point for today. Thank you.